Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Boy, I found some information that would just make your hair stand on end. Early this morning, about 4:49 a.m. local time, close to Anchorage, Alaska, there was a magnitude 4.0 earthquake. USGS has it listed as a magnitude 3.9, and this is right along within the Castle Mountain Fault Zone, right across the way from Anchorage. Going to the swarm program, here is the earthquake. Here's the spectrogram for that earthquake. Let me bring it down a little bit. They said it was a 3.9, but you can see here it was actually probably a 4.02. Here on the USGS webpage, there is 12 earthquakes within the last 24 hours. The red line, I don't know if I can zoom in. No, if I zoom in, it goes away. The red line is the Castle Mountain Fault Zone. Alaska has about 24,000 earthquakes every year, a magnitude 7 or greater about once every 2 years. This area, north of Anchorage, has zero building codes. Earthquake country, 24,000 earthquakes a year. No building codes whatsoever, except for maybe easement and electrical, fire. That's it. Okay, I don't know if you can see, but drawn out in red is this area that has absolutely no building codes for earthquakes. I know a lot of people like living in Alaska because of the freedoms, but you wonder about earthquakes. And if I was buying a building there, a house, maybe moving into an apartment building, I would like to know there was some kind of earthquake standards made, enforced. So here we have that county, and they got things about junk and trash, new construction. That falls under septic tanks and flooding and easements and, yeah, setbacks for structures from roads. Things you should think about before you build or buy, and that would be for flooding, fireworks, burn permits, and air quality. New construction and development. You have to plan a review, make sure it's completed by the appropriate fire official. You know, how many feet they have to be set back from roads and other buildings, easements, you know, can't plug up some water, some river, sewage disposal systems. You know, it goes on again about flood hazards, transfers of deeds, noise, traffic. Nothing about how well your building is constructed for earthquakes. Unbelievable. So here we have one hazard map. I don't know if you can see, it's kind of blurry. This is the Castle Mountain Fault. This is the Denali Fault. Here we have the earthquake hazard map and another earthquake hazard map. I'll try to make this bigger. This here in orange, right down here, that's the Castle Mountain Fault Zone. Up here is Denali Fault Zone. Right across over here is Anchorage. The Castle Mountain Fault has a large earthquake about every 700 years. That would be a magnitude 6 or maybe 7.5. The average is 700 years, and that's what's been happening over the last 2,800 years. It has been at least 670 years since the last one struck. 670 years, and they come about every 700 years. The Castle Mountain Fault cuts underneath, the highway here, Highway 3. It also cuts underneath a railroad line that's close to there, close to the town of Houston, or right underneath the town of Houston, evidently. It goes under the Parks Highway. I'm not quite sure where Parks Highway is. Do you guys that live up in this area, do you realize that there is this threat from the Castle Mountain Fault? This fault zone is about 120 miles long, I believe. Many of us know that Alaska is capable of having very large earthquakes. They have them, like I said, once every 2 years. The last one they had was, I believe, in 2018, but I don't know if you can count that one, because that one was way down over here. Let's see if I can find it. Anyways, it was down off over here, going closer to the Aleutian Islands. 2016, there was a magnitude 7.1, and you have no building codes. No building codes whatsoever. Long as it's fire safe, and as long as your septic system isn't polluting the streams and rivers and things like that, go ahead and build. And you could have a magnitude 7.5 earthquake at any time. It's due. I was trying to get a closer view of some of these homes. Looks like we got one being constructed there, but it's hard to go down to the street view because there's so many forests in this area. All right, here's one. And this is what they consider a soft structure. They got the garage underneath. So there's, this thing could just collapse if it doesn't have the proper reinforcement in the lower level where the garage is at. And it looks like, you know, there's probably, the whole area is probably garage underneath. Here's another one that they would classify as a soft structure. See, all open underneath. Yep. And another one looks like this garage has been converted into maybe an apartment. And another one. Yeah, this would all collapse during a major earthquake unless it's reinforced. Do they know that they are built, their homes are built smack dab on the fault? Here's another one. It's been blurred out on Google Earth. I guess they didn't want to show their home here. Yeah, it's been all blurred out. Yep, smack dab on the fault zone. Unbelievable. Let me go back to my map. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.